Hi, I'm Matthew Moskoviak, Senior Associate Editor at CNET, and I'm here with the Polk Audio SurroundBar SDA IHT. Now, IHT stands for Instant Home Theater, and that's a pretty good description of what this product is about. You've got the soundbar, you've got a wireless subwoofer, and that's it. You don't need a separate AV receiver. You connect your component directly to the soundbar SDA. Now, a lot of soundbars you'll see, they have a glossy finish, but the Polk has a matte finish, and we kind of like that understated look. It also has two cradles that it can sit on, but if you take the cradles away, it also has little rubber feet on the bottom, so it'll sit flat. Now, from the front, you'll also notice that it has a pretty bare look. There's no display on the front, which we found to be a little bit confusing. Sometimes when you're adjusting the volume, you won't know if you're at the maximum or if you have a little headroom, so the lack of a display can be a little confusing at times. You'll also notice that there's actually no remote included with the unit. What Polk wants you to do is to program the remote that you use for your TV also to control the SurroundBar SDA. Now, in some cases, that makes it a lot more simple because all you have to do is use one single remote. At other times, what we found is that sometimes it's adjusting the TV's sound, sometimes it's adjusting the Polk sound. It can get a little confusing, so we thought that maybe Polk should have included a remote for situations where that worked better. If you look around back, you'll also see that the connectivity is really limited on this unit. There's only a single analog input. Now, what Polk wants you to do is to run all of your components directly into your TV and then use your TV's output to go directly into here, and that allows you to use more than one device. That works well enough, but when there are other devices such as Sony's HT-CT100 and JVC's THBA1 that offer either HDMI connectivity in the case of the Sony or digital audio inputs in the case of the JVC, we found it a little hard to defend the Polk shortcomings. Now, while we did find the Polk a little underfeatured, we didn't have as many quibbles with the sound. We actually liked the way the Polk sounded a lot. In particular, the blend between the subwoofer and the soundbar was one of the best that we've heard, and we never felt like we could specifically hear the subwoofer. It really just blended into the overall sound. Now, while we did find that the Polk has above average sound, the one aspect that we found was a little bit lacking was overall dynamic impact. When we compared it to some of the ZVox units that we've tested, we found like the ZVox 525 had a little bit more impact. But if you're more concerned with music and audio fidelity rather than just raw power, the Polk is a good choice. Overall, while we really liked the exterior design of the Polk and we liked the way that it sounded, we found it really hard to justify the missing features offered on competitors, especially when they're available for the same or even lower price. I'm Matthew Moskoviak, here with CNET.com, and this is the Polk Audio SurroundBar SDA IHT.
Hi, I'm Molly Wood, host of The Buzz Report, the show about the tech news that everybody's talking about. See it every Friday in high def at CNET.com/buzzreport.